Good morning, YouTubers. This is Pamela, and today I'm going to put out a very short video. I might put out another one later, but I'm going to show you what I personally do when I'm setting up an enclosure for the Manduca moths to be able to fly and then lay the little turquoise teeny weeny eggs that will eventually become your hornworms. Now, keep in mind, I've been doing this a little while, and I happen to have a very tall enclosure, so they really can fly. But you don't need to do that. You can create your own enclosure. You don't have to spend, I think mine was $199, and it was from a random supply company, but you don't have to do that, okay? I really believe that keep the cost down, get creative with yourself. You can figure out how to create a square screened in area. You can do it, you just have to get creative. Now, there's also these on the market right here. I happen to buy this from a college that has an entire line of supplies for butterflies and things like that. But I've seen them everywhere and they kind of bounce. You can use one of these as well. You're just doing it on a smaller scale. It's not a big deal. You can find these anywhere. We have a tractor supply company here. Lowe's might even have it. Or like I said, do what I did yesterday. I went to Walmart and I purchased some screening unit, just some screening. It was like on a roll, and you know, you can create your own. You just have to be a little bit inventive. So, having said that, you just need enough space for your Mandukas to be able to fly. When they emerge from the substrate, from their, what I call cocoon mode, but it's really their chrysalis mode, then they're gonna need to dry their wings and be still for like a half a day or a day. And then from that point on, you gotta work with them, show them where the nectar is. So we'll get into all that, but for now, this is what my unit looks like right now. It's in my living room. Today I'm going to start putting in the substrate. I'm gonna put in some isopods and some springtails just in case. And the biggest issue that I am trying to avoid is when you have moths and you have them drinking nectar, they fling the nectar, you know, and it spills out like it, as they're flying and they're in the nectar and they slip and, you know, it happens. You're gonna have sweet nectar on all the sides of your unit, okay, regardless. So make sure that you have it somewhere where you will not get ants, because the ants will ruin everything. So last year, the reason this had to be emptied is because they came in right here. They snuck in through the screen. So now I have an arsenal of stuff that I'm gonna put to prevent that from happening, but this is why. So down here, I just basically lined the bottom because it is all screened. I lined the bottom with those blue giant Ziplocs that you can put your big blankets and stuff in, and then you can, you know, vacuum it out. But you can use anything, trash bags, whatever, just to keep the dirt from spilling out of your screen. You don't necessarily have to have dirt in the bottom, but I find it's just helpful. If you're going to use one of these, you're going to want to probably not have any kind of dirt. I like to put plants in mine since it's sitting in my living room. I'd like it to be as attractive as possible. And I'm going to use a combination of organic and non-organic soil. I'll get into that when I put the soil in. But anyway, I wanted to start with video one for today of the setup. Again, you can create your own, but you're gonna need something tall enough that as they're flying around and laying the eggs, they're gonna lay them all over the sides. They're gonna just be dotting those eggs everywhere, and the eggs have a coating around them, and it sticks to whatever they press it against. So it's why I like the screen. But again, I'm going to add a lot of things in here, and I'll show you that they'll lay them on. They'll lay them on a lot of things, so you can have control over where the eggs are. All right. Well, that's it. Quick video for today. Stay tuned. I'm going to keep posting videos one after the other. I hope you like it. Hit the thumbs up and ask as many questions as you want. And I promise I'll try to get back to you. Have a good day. And remember, God is great.